people, I bless you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. This is another segment of the Sinner's Pride. Amen. You know, the Sinner's Pride videos come in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. It's a vision that the Lord gave me that it will bless all of us, including myself. Amen. Because you realize that, you know, one of the things that the enemy or Lucifer did in hell is that the Bible called him an accuser of the brethren. I always say that even in heaven, where the angels were not doing anything bad, if he was able to accuse them, how much more on earth? Amen. When we do, you know, the least chance we get with sin. But I want you to understand that Jesus is the sinner's pride, beloved. Jesus is the sinner's pride. So the sinner's pride videos, number one, is to encourage each one of us to go back to the Bible and read the Bible verses that are given. Amen. We are encouraged to go back to the Bible and read the verses that are given. Amen. Today on the sinner's pride, I want us to look at something in the book of Acts chapter 10. Acts chapter 10. You know, when you read the verse 1, the Bible spoke of a man called Cornelius. And the Bible said Cornelius was a centurion. Now, a centurion is like an army commander. A centurion is someone who commands, who controls a lot of soldiers. Amen. A centurion is a person of a higher rank, a higher pedigree in the army. Amen. And so, remember one day a centurion told Jesus that I am a man under authority. I have people under me. I tell this one, go, and they will go. I am a powerful man. That is how a centurion is. Amen. But the Bible says in the book of Acts chapter 10 that there was a centurion called Cornelius. The Bible says he was a devout man. He was a God-fearing man, a man of kind gesture, a man with a good heart. Amen. And when you read further, you know, the Bible says God, you know, he was praying, he was fasting and praying. And an angel of the Lord, he saw in a vision that an angel of the Lord led him to go and call for Peter, or Simon Peter. Amen. But you know, whilst he was having that vision, the Lord also appeared to Peter himself. And you know, you realize that in the vision, the Bible says Peter saw, you know, the feet of various animals. And the Lord told Peter that kill the beast, kill one of it and eat it. And you know, and according to the Mosaic law, according to the law of Moses, you know, it was unclean for them to eat. But the Bible said, Peter said, no, I can't do this because it's unclean. And the Bible said, God said, listen, if I am giving you an instruction, you have to follow it. Amen. And the Bible said, Peter did what? He followed the instruction. If you obey what the Lord said, amen. And so once he came out of the trance or the vision, the Bible said, he was told that he had some visitors because Cornelius, the centurion, had also sent his servants to go and get, to go and bring Peter to him. Hallelujah. Acts chapter 10. Now, you realize that when they had a conversation, now from verse 27 going, especially the verse 30, Peter said, oh, now I now understand God, because God is not a respecter of person. Beloved, you know, the centurion, Cornelius, was a Gentile. And Gentiles were considered unrighteous. You know, Gentiles were considered sinners. You know, Gentiles were considered, you know, people that were not loved. But listen, look at what happened over here. The Lord spoke to Peter and said, go to the house of the centurion, a person that the people that are considered sinners, the people that are considered, you know, enemies of God, that is where I am sending you to go. And so Peter said, now I know, I understand that God is indeed no respecter of persons. I believe you've heard that before. It is in the Bible, in the book of Acts chapter 10. Amen. Peter said, now I understand that God is no respecter of persons. Beloved, this is how the ministry of Peter began. Yes. This is how the Holy Spirit baptism was publicly made known. Amen. Because the Bible says when Peter began to pray for them in the house of Cornelius, the Bible said they began speaking in different languages. And the Bible said Peter, who was not a learned man, Peter who was shy, Peter who knew nothing, from there, the Bible said Peter began to speak with authority. They began to speak in different dialects, in different tongues, and that was where the ministry of Peter greatly began. The Gentile's house. The sinner's house. Amen. Listen, let me tell you why, you know, Cornelius or the Gentiles, Cornelius for this matter, shouldn't even, you know, if it comes to our human dispensation, he wasn't even worthy. It's because the Bible says he was a centurion. Amen. Beloved, when you read the Bible in the book of Matthew 27, you know, that is where Jesus Christ was being crucified. When you read the verse 27, the Bible says, and the soldiers of the governor, which is Pontius Pilate, amen. The soldiers of the governor, you know, they were casting lots on the things, on the outfit of Jesus Christ. You know, these are the soldiers who pierced Jesus. Amen. Remember, the Bible says when after Jesus gave up and there was an earthquake, one of the soldiers declared that this is indeed the Son of God. His name was not mentioned. But Cornelius is believed to be the first, he's believed to be the first convert, the first Gentile that was converted to receive, you know, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. I'm not saying I cannot be bold to say it is Cornelius, but I believe, I wouldn't doubt that if it was Cornelius who repented at the crucifixion, at the crucifixion of Jesus Christ. Amen. Now watch this. So Cornelius, when you read the verse 1 of Acts chapter 10, the Bible says Cornelius was a centurion of the Italian band. Amen. And Pontius Pilate was an Italian king. Amen. Even though Jesus Christ was killed in Israel, that, you know, so it was a Passover. You know, they did not gather there just to go and kill Jesus. It was an occasion that people from different places would travel to Italy, to Rome. Amen. And so you want to believe that, you know, as a king, he will bring the best of his army, the best of his soldiers, the commanders around him. Amen. If the king himself wants anything to be executed, I believe he will use the centurions, the leaders, the men with authority. And I believe, I mean, Cornelius was one of them. Amen. But guess what? As to whether or not it was Cornelius who pierced Jesus, as to whether or not it was Cornelius who received Jesus at the crucifixion, I want you to understand that Cornelius was a Gentile, someone that is considered a sinner. But God, the Holy Spirit of God, came from, I mean, in his house. Amen. And the people started speaking in tongues. And that was the beginning of the ministry of kingdom. God revealed himself to Cornelius. This is the sinner's prayer. Jesus indeed is the sinner's prayer. He is indeed no respecter of persons. Just avail yourself. He wants to speak to you too. He wants to send you too. Like Cornelius, like a Gentile, he wants to cleanse you. And so he told Peter that, listen, what I have cleansed, what I have purified is pure. Amen. God is not in you. God is indeed not a respecter of persons. This is the sinner's prayer for you. I believe it's been a blessing. Please go back to the Bible and read the whole of Acts chapter 10. Study about Cornelius. And I bet you will know that Cornelius has something to do with the crucifixion of Jesus. God bless you. This is Jesus Center.